Section 173 of the Companies Act, Meetings of Board. So every company shall hold at least 4 meetings, right, in a year. So first question will be, how many board meetings to be conducted in a year? So every company shall hold the first meeting of the board of directors within 30 days of the date of its incorporation, and thereafter hold a minimum number of 4 meetings of its board of directors every year. So in case of first, within 30 days, thereafter hold minimum 4 meetings of its board every year. Every year is calendar year, so it will be 5. At the first year it will be 5, right? What can be interpretation? Interpretation: in the first year of incorporation, company has to do, has to conduct 5 meetings. How it is 5? In the first year, the company has to conduct 5 board meeting. How? First board meeting within 30 days, 1 meeting, thereafter 4 board meeting in a year. By that logic, it will be 5. So section 173 deals with these meetings of the board. So according to this section, first, frequency of the board meetings, subsection 1, first board meeting. Every company here, every company, okay, shall hold the first meeting of BOD within 30 days of its incorporation. Subsequent board meeting, every company shall hold minimum 4 meetings every year. Interpretation: calendar year, provided that the gap between two consecutive board meetings shall not be more than 120 days. That is one more point. So interval for conducting board meeting, not more than 120 days. However, the CG may by notification direct that these provisions will not apply in relation to any class or descriptions of companies, or will apply in relation thereto, subject to such exceptions, modifications or conditions as may be specified in the notification. So at least in the case of section 8 company, at least one board meeting for every 6 months. That we will see exception is there. So the gap between two meetings should not be more than 120 days. So in case of section 8 company, at least one board meeting for every 6 months will satisfy section 173. Section 8 companies, non-profit organization. at least one board meeting. For every 6 months. So 2 board meeting, one in each half year. But it does not say minimum time gap between 2 board meetings. That is very important. There may be an interpretation in such a way that June 30th and 1st July is considered as 2 board meeting. But going by reasonable construction, it may be assumed that the minimum time gap shall be 90 days between 2 board meeting. Exceptions, that is as per section 173 subsection 5. OPC small company, dormant company shall deem to be have comply with the provisions of section 173. At least one meeting of the board directors have been conducted in each half of the calendar year, and the gap between the two meetings is not less than 90 days. So it is given in subsection 5. Provided on OPC in which there is only one director on its board of directors, it shall not be required to hold at least one board meeting in each half of the calendar year. Thus, it is exempt from the following in the provisions of the section 173 subsection 5. So OPC will be exempted again. So section itself mentions the time gap between the two meetings is not less than 90 days in case of OPC small company and dormant company. Small company OPC small company at least 90 days between the meetings, that is as per section 173 subsection 5. This is section 173 subsection 1. Subsection 1. Here subsection 5. So section 8 also will be applicable as per notification. Subsection 2, participation in the board meeting. So participation in the board meeting, subsection 2. Section 173 subsection 2 allows directors to attend board meetings in the following manners. Directors may attend the board meeting in person, that is physically, through video conferencing, other audio visual means as may be prescribed under rule 3 of the company's meetings board and its rules 2014. So section 173 subsection 2, participation. So mode of participation in the board meeting, how it is done, it can be also video conferencing.
the participation of directors in a meeting of the board may either by person, that is physically, or through video conferencing. Or other audiovisual means. Other audiovisual means which are capable of recording, recognizing, participation. Recording and recognizing the participation is the condition of the directors, and of the recording and storing the proceedings of such meeting along with the date and the time shall be counted to be valid board meeting. Point to be noted that director, if he notify the company's intention of participating in meeting electronically, that valid for period of 1 year. He has to intention has to tell to the company that he has participating through video conferencing, that will be valid for 1 year. One more point is the register which are to be kept in the board meeting and which require sign of the directors attending the meeting is deemed to have signed if they expressed their consent if they are attending through video conferencing. If they are attending video conferencing, they have to sign in the register. The notice needs to be sent even if articles of association of the company provides for predetermined intervals. So that is has to be sent. Such AV means should be capable of recording, recognizing the participation of the directors, of recording and storing the proceedings of such meetings along with the date and time. However, CG may notify specify such matters as given under Rule 4 of the Companies Rules 2014, meetings of board and its powers, which shall not be dealt with the meeting through video conferencing and other visual means. So certain business not to be conducted in video conferencing, like approval of annual accounts, approval of board's reports, discussion on prospectus, decision regarding amalgamation, merger, acquisition, audit committee regarding consideration of accounts. These business not to be conducted in the video conferencing. Video conferencing or other video audiovisual means audiovisual electronic communication facility employed which enables all the persons participating in a meeting communicate concurrently with each other without an intermediary and to participate effectively in the meeting. As per Rule 4, the following matter shall not be dealt in any meeting held through video conferencing or other visual means. Other visual means approval of annual financial statement, approval of the board's report, approval of the prospectus, the audit committee meetings for consideration of FS including consolidated financial statement, if any, to be approved by the board under subsection 1 of section 134(4) of the Act. Fifth is the approval of the matter relating to amalgamation, merger, demerger, acquisition, takeover. So these are the very important points. Business not to be conducted in AV means, audiovisual means, or video conference. So 5 points are there possible MCQ question. approval of annual accounts, approval of board's report, discussion with regard to prospectus, issue of prospectus, discussion with regard to amalgamation, merger, acquisition, etc. The last point is number 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 5 is audit committee. Audit committee meeting regarding consideration of accounts. Some points, some of the key points related to meetings of the board that are held through conferencing or AV means as provided in Rule 3 of Companies Rules 2014. Key points and the conduct of the board meeting. Every company shall make necessary arrangement to avoid failure of video or AV connection. Every company, who is the responsible secretary or the president of the chairman of the board meeting. So every company shall make necessary arrangement. The chairperson of the meeting, the company secretary, if any, shall take due and reasonable care toward to safeguard the integrity of the meeting by ensuring the sufficient security and identification procedure to ensure availability of proper video conferencing or AV equipment, facilities providing transmission of the communications for effective participation of the directors and other authorized participants at the board meeting. Okay. C. To record proceedings and prepare the minutes of the meeting. To store for safekeeping and marking the tape recordings or other electronic recording mechanism as a part of the records of the company at least before the time of completion of the audit of that particular area here. To ensure that no person other than the concerned director are attending or have access to the proceedings of the meeting through video conferencing mode or other visual means. To ensure that the participants attending the meeting through AV means are able to hear and see other participants clearly during the course of the meeting. However, the differently able person may make a request to the board allow a person to accompany him. So who is responsible for a meeting? Chairperson and secretary shall take due care and reasonable care. MCQ. Notice of the meeting and the further process shall be sent to all directors in accordance with the provision of the section 173 subsection 3, that is with regard to the notice. So shall be sent to all the directors. B. Shall inform the directors regarding the options available to them in participate through video conferencing mode or other AV means along with all other information to enable the director to participate through such mode. A director intended to participate through AV, video conferencing mode or other AV means shall communicate his intention to the chairman or the company secretary to the company of the company. So if the director intends to attend meeting through video conferencing or other EVM means, he has to inform to the director or secretary. This intimation will be valid for 1 year. That is, once he intends to attend the meeting through video conferencing or other EVM means, it will be valid only for 1 year, not more than 1 year. If a director intends to participate through video conferencing or other visual means, he shall give prior intimation to the effect to enable the companies to make arrangement in this behalf. The director who desires to participate may intimate his intention of participation through the electronic mode at the beginning of the calendar year, and such declaration shall be valid for 1 calendar year. 1 year is calendar year. In the absence of any such intimation from the director, it shall be assumed that he will attend the meeting in person. So if any intimation is not given for video conference or other audiovisual means, then it is default that he will present in person. Process of a roll call at the meeting. Director participate in a meeting through video conferencing or other AV means shall be counted for the purpose of quorum unless he is to be excluded for any items of business under any provision of the act or the rules. So roll calling is required. So for quorum, for quorum also this will be counted at the time of roll call process with regard to video conference. Scheduled venue of the meeting as mentioned in the notice convening the meeting shall be deemed to be the venue of the meeting which is conducted through video conferencing or other means, other AV means authorized under these rules, or and all the recordings at such meeting shall be deemed to have been made at that place. Circulation draft minutes of the meeting among all the directors within 15 days of the meeting, either in writing or in electronic mode as may be decided by the board. So notice within at least 7 days before, and the circulation of draft minutes within 15 days, electronic mode or by writing. After completion of the meeting, minutes shall be entered in the minute book signed by the chairperson. So that is with regard to the video conference. So one more thing is, as per rule 32 of the company's rules 2014, cast duty on chairperson of the meeting and the company secretary to take due and reasonable care to record the proceedings and prepare the minutes of the meeting. That is as per rule 32. Rule 3, sub rule 2. 2 of the company's rules 2014, meeting of boards and its powers to rules. So who is responsible? Chairperson of the meeting and the company secretary. He has the due care and reasonable care to record the proceedings and the preparing the minutes of the meeting. In case of a video recording cannot be retrieved, the chairperson and the company secretary should prepare the minutes on the basis of their notings and thereafter seek confirmation of the all the director present personally or through video conferencing. So one of the condition is that video recording should be retrieved, correct? But if it is not possible, then company secretary and the chairperson person should prepare the minutes on the basis of their notings. After that, seek the confirmation of all the directors present personally or through video conferencing. Then as per rule 12B of the company's rules 2014, every director who attend the meeting, whether personally or through video conferencing or other AV means, shall confirm or give his comments in writing about the accuracy of recording of the proceeding of that particular meeting in a draft minutes within 7 days or some reasonable time as decided by the board after the receipt of the draft minutes, failing which his approval shall be presumed. This is with regard to the recording of the process, shall give the confirmation. Now we'll, in case of when the quorum is present physically, then the directors can participate through video conference. Even vote is counted, that I informed. Quorum also counted. Notice calling for the meeting. Length of notice: a meeting of the board shall be called by giving not less than 7 days notice in writing to every director at his address registered with the company, and such notice shall be sent to by hand delivery or by post or by electronic means. In case the company sends notice by speed post, registered post, on additional 2 days shall be added to the 7 days. Okay, so that is subsection 3. Notice of the board meeting, subsection 3. Period of notice: at least 7 days of notice in writing to all the directors at registered address, sent by hand or by post or by electronic means. What about the shorter notice? In case of registered post or a speed post, additional 2 days is there. What about the shorter notice? Shorter notice than 7 days to transact an urgent meeting, at least one independent director, if any, shall be present. So at least one independent director should be present. In absence, decision taken at such meeting shall be circulated to all the directors and shall be final only on the ratification thereof by at least one independent director, if any. If one independent director is not present at that meeting, then the circulation should be sent to all the directors and the ratified by at least one independent director in case of shorter notice, that is lesser than 7 days notice for urgent business. Option to participate through video conferencing mode or other AV means. Rule 3: notice of the meeting shall inform the directors regarding the option available to them to participate through video conferencing mode or other AV means, and shall provide all the necessary information to enable the directors to participate through the video conferencing mode or other AV means. On receival of notice, a director intending to participate through video conferencing or other AV means shall communicate his intention to the chairperson or the company secretary of the company in prior, in advance. No intimation from director of his participation through the electronic mode. It shall be assumed that the director shall be attending meeting. If the director does not reply back whether he is attending the meeting through video conferencing or any other AV means, then it is assumed that director shall attend the meeting in person. So again, is shorter notice valid? Yes, shorter notice to transact urgent business is permitted subject to the condition. First one, at least one independent director should be there, right? If any, shall be present. In case absence of independent director from such meeting, decision taken at such meeting shall be circulated to all the directors and shall be final only on ratification thereof by at least one independent director. Then question comes, to whom shall the notice be given? Notice shall be given to both alternative as well as original director. In addition, even to foreign directors to his registered address with the company, even maybe a foreign address. Registered post, speed post, hand delivery, email are considered as a recognized mode. Anyone. Whether the agenda needs to be given in the notice calling for the board meeting, that is one of the question asked in the RTP. Whether the agenda needs to be given in the notice calling for the board meeting. Agenda for the board meeting need not be included in the notice calling for board meeting, because Companies Act or a provision does not provide a content for the notice. That is the reason. So no need of the agenda, but as a good corporate practice, agenda can be attached. It is almost necessary. It is almost necessary to include the agenda in the practical world, but as per Companies Act, there is a no provision provided for the content of the agenda. So penalty, what is penalty for the contravention? Penalty for failure to give notice, the act under section now comes 173(4). Section 173(3), notice 7 days, register post 7+2, shorter notice, yes, valid for urgent transaction, one independent director, no independent director, then ratification by at least one independent directors, then it will be given to all the directors, alternate as well as original director, even for the foreign director also. Agenda need not be required. Then comes penalty. Section 173 subsection 4. Has prescribed a penalty of ₹25,000 on every officer of the company whose duty is to give the notice under this section and who has failed to do so. ₹25,000. According to SS1, any director of a company may at any time summon this is officer, every officer of the company means any director of a company may at any time summon the meeting of the board and the CS, or where there is a no CS, any person authorized by the board in this behalf on the requisition of a director shall convene a meeting of the board in consultation with the chairman or in his absence the MD or in his absence whole time director, where is in any unless otherwise provided in the articles. That is who is responsible. Penalty of a ₹25,000. Now we will see examples. So we'll write penalty ₹25,000. But one thing is, relaxation is given for OPC. Domat company, small company, startup, private company also. OPC, small company, domat company, startup company shall be deemed to have been complied with the provisions of this section if at least one meeting of the board of directors has been conducted in each of the calendar year. he already explained that one. The gap between the two meeting is not less than 90 days. Nothing contained in this section shall apply to OPC which is there is only one director on its board of directors. So this section will not applicable to the OPC. Note. What is the note? Startup company means registered under Department of Industrial Promotion Board as startup. For that also relaxation is there. For normal private limited company there is no exemption under this section. And one more note is that board meeting can be called on public holiday but not on national holiday. Then we will go on to examples. We have examples. Seafood Limited, that is the first example. Seafood Limited, a public limited company, was incorporated on 1st April 2016. The company has conducted 4 meetings during the financial year 16-17, 6th April, 28th August, 30th September, 30th March. Has the company contravened the provisions of the Companies Act in respect of the conduct of the meeting? 1st April incorporated, within 30 days first board meeting is required. Yes, 6th April, then 28th August, 30th September, 30th March. 1, 2, 3, 4. Company has contravened the section 173 of the Companies Act in respect of the conduct of the subsequent board meetings. Yes, 4 meetings required. See, this is the first meeting. 1, 2, 3. Only 3 meetings have been done. In respect of the conduct of the subsequent board meeting, there is a contravention. The gap between the two consecutive board meetings, that is a meeting held on 6th April and 28th August, is 143 days, which is more than 120 days. And similarly, the gap between the meeting held on 30th September and the 30th March is 181 days, which is again more than 120 days. So the thing is, there should have been 5 meetings. First meeting, within 30 days of incorporation, that is done. Then subsequent meeting, 4 meetings, gap should not be more than 120 days. This is failed. Second question, will your answer differ if the company was incorporated under Section 8 Companies Act 2013? Yes. In the case of company incorporated under Section 8 of the Companies Act, since the board meeting have been conducted within 6 calendar months, so there is no contravention of the provisions related to holding or of the board meetings. This is as per notification, relaxation or exception given. Next question. The Board of Directors of Infotech Consultants Limited registered in Kolkata proposes to hold the next board meeting in the month of May 2014. They seek your advice in respect of the following matters. Can the board meeting to be held in Chennai through video conferencing when all the directors of the company resides at Kolkata? Place of the board meeting is not given by the provisions by the Companies Act, so they can do so when all the directors of the companies are yes. There is no provision in the Companies Act 2013 under which the board meeting must be held at any particular place. So no provision is provided. It particular place. Therefore, there is no difficulty in holding the board meeting at Chennai even if all the directors of the company reside at Kolkata and the registered office is situated at Kolkata, provided the requirements regarding the holding of a valid board meeting and the other provisions relating to the signing of the register of contracts, taking roll calls, etc., are complied with. Next question. Is it necessary that the notice of the board meeting would specify the nature of the business to be transacted? Nature of, again, content of the notice of the board meeting is not given by the Companies Act. So it is not necessary, but good practice should be. Section 173, subsection 3, notice of the meeting. Provides for the giving of a notice of every board meeting not less than 7 days to every director. There is no provision in the Act laid on the contents of the meeting. So again, no provision for the no provision in the Act laid on the content of the notice. Hence, it may be construed that the notice may be interpreted as intimation of the meeting and does not necessarily include the sending of the agenda of the meeting. However, considering the importance of board meetings and the responsibility placed on the directors for decision taken at the meetings, it is inevitable for them to properly prepare and informed about the items to be disclosed at the board meeting, the agenda, setting out the business to be transacted at the meeting, and notes on agenda shall be given to the directors at least 7 days before the date of the meeting, unless the articles prescribe a longer period as a matter of good secretarial practice. The articles of association of the company may take it mandatory to do so in almost all cases. XYZ Limited is a foreign collaborator in ABC Limited. Incorporated in India under the Companies Act 2013, the foreign collaborator holds 49% of the whole shareholding. The board meeting of the ABC Limited are usually held in India, and sometimes meeting of the board are called at a very short notice, for which there is a provision in the articles of association that during such situations notices of the meetings of the board can be sent by email. State in this connection whether such provision in the articles of association of a foreign collaborative company is valid. In terms of the proviso to section 173 subsection 3 of the Companies Act 2013, a meeting of the board may be called at shorter notice to transact urgent business, subject to the condition that at least one independent director, if any, shall be present at the meeting. No exception is made for any class or classes of companies. Further, under section 173 subsection 3, a meeting of the board shall be called by giving not less than 7 days notice in writing to every director at is registered with the company, and such notice shall be sent by hand delivery or by post or by electronic means. If we examine above provision, it is clear that the notice shall be sent by hand delivery or by post or electronic means. Hence, the sending of notice by emails is an ordinary mode of sending notice of the board meeting under the Companies Act 2013. Therefore, in the given case, shorter notice is legally permitted, with the only condition being presence of the quorum and at least one independent director. The provision of the articles in this regard is not relevant, as the position provisions of the articles in this regard is not relevant, as the position is amply clear in the Act itself. So this is with regard to section 173 of the Companies Act, subsection 1. First meeting within 30 days, minimum number of meetings, subsequent meeting, 4 meetings every year means calendar year, not more than 120 days of gap between the two meeting. Exceptions, subsection 5, OPC, small company, Domat company, Section 8 company, at least one board meeting for every 6 months, time gap at least 90 days between the meetings. Here not more than 180 days, here it can be more than 90 days, at least 90 days required. 173 subsection 2, participation in the board meeting, in person, video conferencing, other means, business not to be conducted in AV means, approval of annual accounts, approval of boards, report, prospectus, amalgamation, merger, acquisition, etc. Audit committee meeting regarding consideration of the accounts, recording and recognizing of participation in AV means required. So rule 3 sub rule 2, chairperson secretary is responsible for due care and responsible care for the AV or video conference. Directors intend to attend the meeting through VC or other audiovisual means, they can intimate to the company secretary or a chairperson of the meeting. That will be valid for one calendar year. Intimation, video conference.